Moses, therefore, said to Joshua,
so that one who belongs to God may be competent.
All the more reason to trust that the parent of all parents will give his children what they need. Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace, mercy, peace from God our Father through the risen Savior be with you always.
And with your spirit.
A warm welcome to everyone, and a very special welcome to the Schultz and Tomlinson families as they celebrate new life for them, as well as new life for our faith community as we begin the initiation process for their daughter. And so we begin, first of all, with the naming of your child. Parents, what name have you given your child?
Emmeline Grace.
Emmeline Grace. And any particular reason for choosing those names?
She was named after her great-great-grandma, Emma.
Great-great-grandma, Emma? Mm-hmm. And Grace?
Just the name we liked.
It's a wonderful name. That was my grandmother. My grandmother was Grace Ann. That's the heart of our faith. Amazing Grace. And you have asked to have your child, pardon me, you have asked, what do you ask of God's church for Emmeline Grace?
Life in Christ.
Life in Christ. You have asked to have your child baptized into life in Christ. In doing so, you are accepting the responsibility of training her in the practice of the faith. It will be your duty to bring her up to keep God's commandments as Christ taught us, by loving God and our neighbor. Do you clearly understand what you are undertaking? And godparents, James and Rochelle, are you ready to help these parents in their duty as Christian parents? And people of St. James, are you ready to help these parents and godparents in their duty as Christian parents?
We are.
Emmeline Grace, the Christian community welcomes you with great joy. In its name, I claim you for Christ our Savior by the sign of the cross. I will now trace the cross on your forehead and invite your parents and godparents and sisters to do the same. It's so much fun when they're a little older. She's 7 months, and so you can just see the reactions in her face. Okay, if you'd like to have a seat, please. And we pray for a moment in the quiet of our hearts. Lord, tireless guardian of your people, always ready to hear the cries of your chosen ones, teach us to rely night and day on your care. Support our prayer lest we grow weary. Impel us to seek your enduring justice and your ever-present help. We ask this through Jesus, our Lord and our brother, who lives with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A proclamation from the book of Exodus. In those days, Amalek came and waged war against Israel. Moses therefore said to Joshua, "Pick out certain men, and tomorrow go out and engage Amalek in battle. I will be standing on top of the hill with the staff of God in my hand." So Joshua did as Moses told him. He engaged Amalek in battle after Moses had climbed to the top of the hill with Aaron and Hur. As long as Moses kept his hands raised up, Israel had the better of the fight. But when he left his hands rest, Amalek had the better of the fight. Moses' hands grew tired, so they put a rock in place for him to sit on. Meanwhile, Aaron and Hur supported his hands, one on one side and one on the other side, so that his hands remain steady till sunset. And Joshua mowed down Amalek and his people with the edge of the sword. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A proclamation from the second letter of St. Paul to Timothy. Beloved, remain faithful to what you have learned and believed, because you know from whom you learned it, and that from infancy you have known the scriptures, which are capable of giving you wisdom for salvation through faith in Christ Jesus. All scripture is inspired by God and is useful for teaching, for refutation, for correction, and for training in righteousness, so that one who belongs to God may be competent, equipped for every good work. I charge you in the presence of God and of Christ Jesus, who will judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingly power, proclaim the word. Be persistent, whether it is convenient or inconvenient. Convince, reprimand, encourage through all patience and teaching. The word of the Lord.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of good news according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
May the Lord be in our minds, on our lips, and in our hearts. Jesus told his disciples a parable about the necessity for them to pray always without becoming weary. He said, there was a judge in a certain town who neither feared God nor respected any human being. And a widow in that town used to come to him and say, "Render a just decision for me against my adversary." For a long time, the judge was unwilling, but eventually he thought, "While it is true that I neither fear God nor respect any human being, because this widow keeps bothering me, I shall deliver a just decision for her, lest she finally come and strike me." The Lord said, "Pay attention to what the dishonest judge says. Will not God then secure the rights of his chosen ones who call out to him day and night? Will he be slow to answer them? I tell you, he will see to it that justice is done for them speedily. But when the Son of Man comes, will he find faith on earth? The Gospel of the Lord. I find it fascinating to read of different instances and events about Pope Francis. I was reading the National Catholic Reporter this week, and they described his visit to Assisi October 4th, being the feast of St. Francis. And of course, since the Pope took that as his patron, as his name, it was very fitting that he visit the hometown of St. Francis October 4th. Well, one thing that got my attention in the report was that he got together with all the priests of the area, the priests of Assisi and the general area, and he was very direct, very down to earth, very blunt. He said, "Don't be boring in your homilies." Uh-oh. So, there's quite a challenge. Don't be boring in your homilies. I've been kind of bugging our pastoral staff in recent weeks with a favorite slogan of mine, less is more. Less is more, to try to get rid of the clutter we have around the facilities, maybe have a little shorter announcements at Mass, maybe the petitions being just a little bit more brief. Less is more, but I have to confess that I'm not always real consistent, because if I have a choice, I always want to do all the verses of every hymn, in case you haven't noticed. Less is more. Well, Jesus in the recent weeks has been using a method that rabbis often used in order to teach, and it's going from the lesser to the greater. For example, in recent weeks we heard about Jesus saying that which parent among you would give your child a snake if he asked for bread, or a scorpion if he asked for an egg. And Jesus said, if you, with all of your faults and failures as parents, know how to give your children good things, all the more reason to trust that the parent of all parents will give his children what they need. The Holy Spirit, going from the lesser to the greater. And we have it again today with the story of the widow bugging that unjust judge, persistent in going after him. And again, not because he was a good judge or a fair judge, but because he was fearful she might hit him, he gives her the justice that she persistently requests. And again, Jesus says, if this unjust judge is willing to respond because of her persistence, all the more reason for you to be persistent in your prayer, to be persistent in bringing your case, your needs to our Heavenly Father, going from the lesser to the greater. Very powerful teaching method that rabbis would employ. And so we have a good focus this weekend on the gift of prayer and how valuable prayer is, and to kind of help us grow in our prayer. Isn't it interesting that as long as Moses held his hands high, they were successful. But as he became tired and started to let them down, they started losing. And so what do? They prop them up, one on either side, hands held high. That very traditional gesture of prayer, of openness to God, expressing trust and confidence in God. And so that's one reason why we hold our hands high and open when we pray the Lord's Prayer, and why we hold hands. Moses was supported by others in his prayer so he could be consistent, persistent we support one another in our prayer. We show it symbolically when we hold hands and open our arms during the Our Father, and we show it when we come together for communal prayer. We support one another in our prayer. What a powerful message that is in order to help us be persistent in prayer. We have the support of one another, the support of the community, in order to grow in our prayer. That's not to say that we shouldn't pray by ourselves. In other parts of the scripture, we hear how Jesus went off alone in solitude and prayed. But we have that blending of prayer in solitude as well as communal prayer. Where two or more are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst of them. And so the scriptures this weekend kind of stir us up to take a look at our prayer. Are we persistent in prayer? Do we trust that our God will ultimately give us maybe not all we want, but certainly will provide all we need? You are all we have. You give us what we need. Our lives are in your hands, O Lord. Our lives are in your hands. Page 31. You are all we have. You give us what we need. Our lives are in your hands, O Lord. Our lives are in your hand.
At the presentation of gifts, you will hear the rest of the prayer.
Are we doing that one?
We are.
Wonderful, we're on the same page. And you probably noticed we are recording this liturgy, so maybe good Pope Francis will see it. So we continue celebrating the initiation of Emmeline Grace, and I invite all of you, her family and relatives, friends, to follow me to the font. We'll go this way to give us an opportunity to sing the Litany of Saints, and any children in church as well. If you'd like to see better, please feel welcome to come to the font. So we'll just proceed this way.
Lord, have mercy.
My dear sisters and brothers, God uses the sacrament of water to give his divine life to those who believe in him. Let us turn to him and ask him to pour his gift of life from this font on this child he has chosen. I invite everyone to respond, blessed be God. Father, God of mercy, through these waters of baptism, you have filled us with new life as your very own children.
Blessed be God.
From all who are baptized in water and the Holy Spirit, you have formed one people, united in your Son, Jesus Christ.
Blessed be God.
You have set us free and filled our hearts with the Spirit of your love, that we may live in your peace.
Blessed be God.
You call those who have been baptized to announce the good news of Jesus Christ to people everywhere.
Blessed be God.
And you have called your child, Emmeline Grace, to this cleansing water, that she may share in the faith of your church and have eternal life. By the mystery of this consecrated water, lead her to a new and spiritual birth, for we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We ask you, Father, with your Son, to send your Holy Spirit upon the water of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the death of baptism rise also with him to newness of life. Parents and godparents, you have come here to present this child for baptism. By water and the Holy Spirit, she is to receive the gift of new life from God who is love. On your part, you must make it your constant care to bring her up in the practice of the faith. See that the divine life which God gives her is kept safe from the poison of sin, to grow always stronger in her heart. If your faith makes you ready to accept this responsibility, renew now the vows of your own baptism. Reject sin. Profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the church, and this is the faith in which this child is about to be baptized. And as Emmeline Grace's parents speak and godparents speak promises for her, I invite all of you to join them by responding, "I do." Do you reject sin so as to live in the freedom of God's children?
I do.
Do you reject the glamour of evil and refuse to be mastered by sin?
I do.
Do you reject Satan, father of sin and prince of darkness?
I do.
Do you believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died, and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
This is our faith and the faith of the Church. We are proud and grateful to profess it in Christ Jesus our Lord. She is very eager to get in there. Is it your will that Emmeline Grace be baptized in the faith of the church we have just professed with you?
Yes.
Emmeline Grace, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Emmeline Grace, God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, has freed you from sin and given you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit and welcomed you into his holy people. He now anoints you with the chrism of salvation. As Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so may you live always as a member of his body unto everlasting life. Amen. And if you would please put the white stole on Emmeline Grace. Emmeline Grace, you have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white stole the outward sign of your Christian dignity, with your family and friends to help you by word and example, bring that dignity unstained to the everlasting life of heaven. Amen. Oops. Receive the light of Christ. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. She is to walk always as a child of the light. May she keep the flame of faith alive in her heart. And when the Lord comes, may she go out to greet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom. The Lord Jesus made the deaf hear and the mute speak. May he soon touch your ears to hear his word and your lips to proclaim his praise to the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let's show our welcome and congratulations. Please rise. Each week we pause at this point of the Mass praying for those who are in need. Let us be persistent in asking God to bring healing and peace to our weary world.
Our response will be, "Hear us, O Lord." On this World Mission Sunday, let us pray for the Church, for believers everywhere who continue to live the Jesus story in this time and place. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For forgiveness, for reconciliation among enemies, for those who have hurt us or who have suffered because of our actions. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For charity and respect for those who are different from us, for those we find difficult to love. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For hope, for trust instead of suspicion, for optimism instead of cynicism, for faith in God's love for the world. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For health for those who are sick or chronically ill or hospitalized or homebound, and for all the prayers found in our Book of Intentions. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For those we love most in the world, for the children we hold dear, for those who love us and give meaning to our day. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
For Emmeline Grace, and for the parents and godparents, may they live their faith for their children. O God, we pray.
Hear us, Lord.
We remember those who have died and for their families who mourn their passing, and especially Jerry Meisenberg and Dolores Escu, for whom this Eucharist is offered. O God, we pray.
Hear us,
Lord. You bring justice to your people, O God of love and mercy. Listen to our prayer. Inspire us to work for your justice. For we pray through Christ our Lord.
Presentation song can be found on page 31. You are all we have on page 31.
Thank you.
By the mingling of this water and wine, may all of us come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share our humanity. Pray, friends, that these are gifts, the many gifts of our lives, may all be acceptable to God, our loving Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of God's name, for our good and all God's
name. Amen. Lord God, grant us the gift of serving at your altar with free and generous hearts, that your grace may cleanse all from sin through these very mysteries by which we offer you true worship. For we pray through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty, our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, Lord of heaven and earth. Through your eternal word, you created all things. You govern their course with infinite wisdom. In the word made flesh, you have given us a mediator who has spoken your words to us and called us to be his disciples. He is the way that leads to you, the truth that sets us free, the life that makes our joy complete. Through your Son, you gather into one family women and men created for the glory of your name, redeemed by the blood of the cross, sealed with the Holy Spirit. And so we praise your mighty deeds. We join with the hosts of angels as they proclaim your glory without end. Indeed are you, Lord God, greatly to be praised. Your faithful love attends us as we journey through life. Blessed is your Son, Jesus Christ, who is present among us when his love gathers us together. As once he did for his disciples, Christ now opens the scriptures for us and breaks the bread. Therefore we ask you, merciful Father, send down your Holy Spirit to hallow these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and the blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the eve of his passion and death, while at table with those he loved, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." When supper was ended, he took the cup. Again, he gave you thanks, and handing the cup to his disciples, he said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." And so, Father most holy, we celebrate the memory of Christ, your Son, whom you led through suffering and death on the cross, to the glory of the resurrection, and a place at your right hand. Until Jesus, our Savior, comes again, we proclaim the work of your love, offering you the bread of life, the cup of blessing. Look with favor on the offering of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that was entrusted to us. Through the power of your Spirit of love, count us both now and forever among the members of your Son, whose body and blood we share. Almighty Father, by our sharing in this mystery, enliven us with your Spirit, conform us to the image of your Son, strengthen the bonds of our communion with Francis, our Pope, Jerome and Donald, our bishops, and all who serve your people. Keep your church alert in faith to the signs of the times and eager to accept the challenge of the gospel. Open our hearts to the needs of all, so that sharing their grief and anguish, their joy and hope, we may faithfully bring them the good news of salvation and advance together on the way to your kingdom. Be mindful of our loved ones who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith is known only to you. Lead them to the fullness of the resurrection. Gladden them with the light of your face. When our pilgrimage on earth is complete, welcome us into your heavenly home to dwell with you forever. There with Mary and Joseph, the apostles, the martyrs, Saint James, and all the saints, we shall glorify your name and give you praise through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
Confidently and persistently, we pray the words Jesus taught us.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation,
and may the peace of the Lord Jesus be with you always. We share a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God, our way, our truth, and our life. Blessed are we called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and the soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of our Lord Jesus bring us to life everlasting. I invite forward the ministers of communion for the homebound. We're very grateful that you're able to bring the Eucharist to those who can't be here to help them grow in their friendship with the Lord Jesus as well. And so we send you with our prayer for them. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Foster your life within us, Lord, by the celebration of the heavenly mysteries. Bless us with your help from day to day, and so prepare our hearts for the world to come. For we pray through Christ our Lord. Wonderful, there are no announcements. Less is more. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.
And as we are sent forth, let us sing Song of Good News found on page 34.